Yeah. Namaste, everyone. Today is Naturally Cooling Group 38th webinar, and today topic is about the palm trees and palm jaggery benefits, and what are the ways to extract it, and what are the ways to preserve it, and how to identify pure palm jaggery. And today the presenter is Dr. P.C. Vengaya Garu, and he is a food scientist and technological department in AICRP on palms in Dr. Y.S.R. Horticulture University, Andhra Pradesh. So today we'll discuss more about palm jaggery, and even in the groups I already mentioned why palm jaggery is good and why not sugarcane jaggery, and why palm jaggery takes less water and why sugarcane jaggery takes more water, and like that we have many details, and we do know more details from the Dr. Vengaya Garu. Vengaya Garu, over to you. Sir, 1 minute, sir. Yeah, yes, sir. Now you are audible.
Yes, sir. Good evening to all. Myself, Vengaya, working as a scientist, food science and technology, Dr. Y.S.R. Horticulture University. Today, as per the topic given by sir, is palm trees and palm jaggery benefits, and how to identify the pure jaggery. Why? Because there is so much adulteration in the jaggery and other products also. Although we are working in all products, different products, we developed more than 30 products from the palm tree itself. But today topic is confined to that palm jaggery and its utilization and its identification of adulteration. But there are so many palms, as you all know, so many palms in around our fields, our nurseries, so many palms. I will give a glimpse of other palms which are familiar in India. I will give the details of the commercial palms, wild palms, and some ornamental palms. Then we'll go to our subject. In that, mainly, as you all know, that coconut is the kalparuksha of many areas, mainly in our Andhra Pradesh, in Konasima area, and Kerala, and Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, followed by Andhra Pradesh. Coconut is a famous palm tree which gives many products, and it is a economical palm in the among the all palms. Coconut is the main economic and commercial palm, and after that another commercial palm is date palm. Although it is a very small hectares in India, now it is becoming popular in India as well as in Andhra Pradesh also, in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh also. So many farmers now they started cultivation. And this is also a commercial palm. And another one, that is oil palm. As you all know, now oil palm is the main in South India, as well as Maharashtra up to Bihar. Many farmers cultivating oil palm as a commercial crop. And mainly that processing and oil extraction is the main source of for this oil palm. Then coming to the ergonaut palm. This is in mainly in Kerala. And it is also now as intercrop in coconut in Andhra Pradesh as well as Tamil Nadu, in other areas also. These four are the commercial palms which is cultivating by the farmers, as well as government is supporting in many ways, like Coconut Development Board, like Oil Palm, Oil Federation, like and spices and condiments like that. So many supporting there, government is giving for these four crops. And coming to the ornamental palms, in India, mainly three ornamental palms available. That is a royal palm and a table palm. It is a investor Chinese. It is called as a Chinese palm also name. And another one is a foxtail palm. These three palms used for ornamental purpose and for the commercial business, as well as landscaping and decorative purpose. This importance also increasing day by day. Then coming to the our another palm, it is a dove palm. It is in Gujarat. It is a famous, and it is a branched palmera palm. One can call it as a branched palmera palm. And it is also a single seeded fruits. It is coming, and it is available in the Gujarat and Rajasthan areas. And locally, they are taking for nungu extraction, and some now they initiated tapping in some areas. But it is a very big and branched palms, very difficult to tap. And then coming to the our subject, up to this there are the commercial palms as well as decorative palms, and one this is a branched palms. Then coming to the our sugar palms, which is all are almost all wild palms, and it is a very important, and in our olden days itself they are given very much importance these palms. Gandhi itself told that by using these sugar palms in the rural areas one can improve the health and wealth of the rural population as well as the farmers by using these palms. But another way, maybe lack of manpower, maybe lack of interest in the government side, now these palms are 100% neglected, but so much useful and many utilization is there, and now many countries as well as many states focusing on these areas for extracting natural foods and natural one, and which is abundantly available in the villages. These three palms are Palmyra, which is scientific name is Borassus flabellifer, and it is I am working on the Palmyra palm from A to Z from starting onwards, and there are so many products, main value added products and byproducts and fiber based products, and from this so many products we developed, and this almost more than 30 products we developed from the Palmyra palm itself since last 9 years. And another similar palms is wild date palm. One can call it as a Eetha Chettu in Telugu. It is everywhere you can found in villages along the streams, along the banks of the rivers, along the field bonds. So many palms at the small height to different height. In this also so many types of wild date palms. Why? Because nobody working and nobody developed any varieties and district culture. It is wildly growing. In this also different variation is there. Similarly, sago palm or fishtail palm, scientific name is Caryotyrens. Recently, we focused to work in this palm. It is plenty of palms available in the agency area, high altitude regions of Maredmalli and Araku, and some plain areas also it is available. In tribal area, people are using extracting the toddy from this palm and selling. And main advantage of this palm is it yields more than 30 liters per day. It is average. In some areas, they are telling that it is more than 50 liters also. That's why they are getting more income. From one tree itself, they are getting more than 40,000-50,000 per year, tribal people. And they are giving these trees to higher places for other peoples, 30,000 per month. Interestingly, I found that in some areas, tribal people, they are giving this tree as a dowry of their daughter. See how much important and how much economic value of this palm. And in some areas, it is palm is called as a Talli Pala Chettu. Means the just born babies, they are feeding this juice, that sago palm juice or fishtail palm juice. Why? Because this is having a full of nutrition values and medicinal values. They are considering as a mother palm in tribal areas. Like this, now we are exploring these three wild palms for effective utilization and commercial importance and for health and wealth, to improve the health standards of the people as well as to get the income from these wild palms, which is naturally available in the villages as well as in forest areas. So last 10 years, I am working in mainly Palmyra palm. Recently, I started to work in similar area of wild date palm as well as fishtail palm or sago palm. As you all know, you can see everywhere that Palmyra palm is available. We, from childhood onwards, we are seeing the Palmyra palm. But nobody knows how many years it will give yield. Then how many years it will take to germinate. Then how much quantity it will give. What is the uses? There is no scientific data. So for this, that our government of India, led by that Indian Council of Agriculture Research, started a one scheme, that is All India Coordinator Research Project on Palms. So which is focusing on mainly coconut palm, oil palm, initially in 1978 itself. After that, based on this, some experts' recommendations, that Palmyra palm is included in 1993. Means to identify the allied palms, to study the uses of the palms, and to collect the allied palms, and to develop the hybrids, to develop the tissue culture palms, to identify the best varieties. For this objective, it was started our scheme in 1993 at హార్టికల్చర్ రిజిస్ట్రేషన్ పందిరి మామిడి విచ్ ఈస్ అండర్ డాక్టర్ వైఎస్ఆర్ హార్టికల్చర్ యూనివర్సిటీ అలాంగ్ విత్ అనదర్ సెంటర్ అట్ తమిళనాడు ఇట్ ఈస్ అ కిల్లికులం ఇన్ తిరుచెందూరు డిస్టిక్ తిరునల్వెల్లి డిస్టిక్ ది టూ సెంటర్స్ వర్కింగ్ ఇన్ దిస్ పల్మరా ఫార్మ్ దెన్ వీఆర్ ఫోకసింగ్ ఆన్ ఎర్లియర్ డేస్ వీఆర్ కలెక్టింగ్ ద ఎలైట్ ఫార్మ్స్ త్రూ అవుట్ ద ఇండియా మీన్స్ why because I am giving the all details of the palmara farm which are we are maintaining in our farm itself we collected more than 285 types of the palmara varieties from the different districts of the entire India and we planted and we are maintaining the beautiful garden of more than 17 acres at our station by 4x4 meter spacing and we are evaluating the each and every parameters of the palmara farm similarly recently we started both the wild date palm and sago palm now these are the brief about the different palms which are commercial palms which is directly government supporting as well as the commercial importance of the farmers and ornamental palms and these are sugar palms or wild palms which is highly economical value but we are neglecting and now we submitted report to government also to give the support like coconut now it is under process now coming to the our subject these three palms now we can see that one palmara palm itself it is came to know that in our olden grantha itself there are more than 200 uses from the palmara palm itself see from the leaf onwards trunk and sap fruit and tender fruit and fiber and tuber flower and ripe fruit and spongy endosperm like that so many uses each and every part of the palmara palm it is useful and without giving any nutrition and any irrigation and anything we can observe the how many foods it is giving and an average palm which is a age of more than 25 years it gives more than 200 fruits per year per palm that is a tender fruits one now we can observe in the urban cities metro cities that tender fruit that munjalu each dozen they are selling at the rate of 40 rupees to 50 rupees see how much economic value of this palmara palm by directly consumption of the that nungu or tender fruit similarly so many products so coming to the our subject in palmara jaggery is the it is a ultimate product but there are so many issues in this area nobody working in scientific manner that's why so lot of issues to be taken up in scientific manner so in our scheme we started to focus working on the starting onwards means the tapping collection processing and preservation and making jaggery and shelf life and adulteration each and everything we studied scientifically so if you discuss scientifically it will take more time just briefly first of all for making jaggery first of all we have to know the collection of the sap in jaggery means we will see the along the roadside so many people selling from it is coming from the Chennai some other villages of West Godavari district and they are selling along the roadside just small cubes or small one jaggery but these are all traditional method so there is no improvements from the last more than hundreds of years they are following only traditional method and traditional also they don't know the exact process exact values how to do where to stop these are so many issues but after we focusing our work we standardize the traditional process as well as we developed new process so then coming to our another palm it is the fish tail palm you can see this is the fish tail palm or in jiluga chattu in telugu or caryotyrans or sago palm our kittul palm one can call it as a kittul palm also it is available in Araku Mareadmalli Jagdalpur Chhattisgarh border so many palms now you can observe this palm inner around the our function halls and for decoration purpose also they are using then coming to the wild date palm so in villages one can observe this wild date palm for tapping of the toddy and some fruits it is excellent taste now it is time being it is vanishing by drying up the canals and that natural flow of water and due to the real estate they are removing all the wild date palms along the roadside and whatever Now it is very few we are able to see in the villages also. These are the three. Now recently in Telangana government also under the scheme of Haritaharam, they planted lakhs of this wild date palm plantation. Now it is continuous process. And then coming to the here, now I will go to the process of sap collection and processing, and what are the important parameters, and how to make the jaggery and uses of the jaggery. And it is a jaggery making similar to all palms. It is a sago palm or wild date palm or palmera palm. It is a similar process. That's why no issues. Now, which the work which we did and we concentrated, I will give the brief glimpses. These are the germplasm are collected different types of palms from the entire many districts of from the India, and we are planted and we are maintaining 285 collections we are having. But in this we are not able to found from specific varieties. Why? Because here it is a from the seed it is coming. It is for one tree we collected and planted, but it is giving lot of variation due to wild natural pollination, and there is no hybridization, there is no tissue culture. That's why now our horticulture scientists are focusing in this to develop new varieties. It is under process. Then, and we are using some basic points also I want to discuss here. It is a natural climbing of the traditional tapper with help of the rope, and it is also in from West Godavari district from the Jaggery people. They are see from the one palm itself, how many space one can tap, then how much yield one can extract. In this one palm itself, daily 10 to 15 liters they are getting the at sap or liquid or inflorescence sap, one can call it as, or neera. Generally, we will call it as a neera, fresh drink, unfermented drink. For making jaggery, we have to collect unfermented sap. Either way, it is in old method or which is new method which is developed by us. It is in our farm, we are collecting the traditional method sap collection. See, in Tamil Nadu, they will go to the top of the palm and they will collect the, with a big vessel, and from the different space, they are collecting the neera. So some climbers also developed by some Kerala people. Now we are modified and we are using for palmera also. Basically, it was developed for coconut palm. Now we are using for palmera also. It is another that is a standing type, and this one is a sitting type climber. Now the in common man, suppose anybody can climb the palm tree by using these climbers, but initially it will take some more time. Once it is makes practice, it will be very easy to climb, and very safety also. Then coming to the sap, generally people knows that sap will come only summer season. Tatikallu or Tade, which is available in the only summer, March, April, May. But we developed the to collect the sap throughout the year by extending the tapping position, tapping season. Why? Because generally male palms gives flowering in the October itself. So male palms we can tap in two stages. That is a 15 days spate and 1 month spate. By using these different age spates, by differentiating palms and by grouping the palms, we can extend the season throughout the year, and 9 months we can get more maximum neera, and another some quantity may be less, but we can collect the neera throughout the year. And also we tried so many experiments to improve the quantity of the neera. That is a technical point of view. Already we developed technologies to improve the by using antioxidants and to improve the quantity of neera. Now we are able to already standardize and publish some papers also. One can browse from the Google, palmera type means it will come. Then coming to the spate of the male and female cut portion. Suppose gala, in Telugu we can call it as a gala or inflorescence. It is coming out from the palm. For male flower it will comes October onwards. Generally we will start male tapping in December. Why? Because maximum number of trees give space up to December. Then we will start the male palms in the month of December itself for collecting neera. And after Pongal, on the first week of the February, we'll try to tap the female. And up to the middle or end of the February month, full all female palms gives flowering. Then we can tap the female palms, and female palms we can group from three stages: early stage and mature stage and fruiting stage. By grouping these three stages and female palms itself, we can tap more than 8 months. So see, it is a matured fruit from the palmera, means from the fruit also we can tap the neera. From the we will cut the last fruit, and from there we will collect the neera, and we can use for neera as well as by products and value added products. So then coming to the our main subject, so we have to collect the unfermented sap or unfermented neera. Once it is fermented, call it as toddy or kallu, means there is some alcohol. But for jaggery preparation, we need zero alcohol liquid, that is sap or neera. So in this there are traditional method, means the tapper will add the lime, seashell lime. They will add the lime in the pot itself. Then once that sap is coming from the spade, the drop touches the lime, it will stabilize, it will not ferment. So lime arrest the fermentation. That is the traditional method. The people who are selling the jaggery in the market present, they are using this method only, a traditional method only. By using lime, they are collecting the sap and making the jaggery and selling the in around the streets and around the urban areas. But here are so many issues. Although they are doing very good manner, very perfectly without adulteration, but they don't know how much lime they have to add. Suppose lime is less, that sap is fermented. Suppose lime is more, that jaggery will not come proper way, some excess lime. So then we studied it scientifically, and now we tried how much lime we have to add, like that. Traditional method also standardized. Then coming to the other alternatives to the lime, there are some AFS, anti-fermenting solutions, which is developed by one institute, SCMS Institute of Technology in Kerala. And similarly, Coconut Development Board for coconut neera, they have developed. Same can use it for palma neera. And we also developed one solution by, from the herbal extract. Now we are under the process of that patenting for this collection. So by using this AFS, anti-fermenting solution, it acts similar to lime, and it will not allow to ferment the sap. So and another one, ice box or cool box method. These are developed by CPCR, Central Plantation Crops Research Institute, Kerala. They are developed for coconut, and same thing we implemented for palmera and standardized for the palmera sap of both male, female and fruit neera. So these are the methods available to collect the sap without fermentation, fresh neera, which is useful for fresh drink, jaggery, sugar, candy, chocolate or palm syrup. But for this, all these products, this is the prime importance for while collecting itself. So here we can see this is a traditional method. Lime coating of the pot, and we can put the pot in the collection place in the spade, either male or female. We will collect by using lime method. So that the lime, suppose we have to add lime, some excess for factor of safety. Suppose we are not able to predict how much neera yielding. Sometimes based on the climatic factors, today some neera quantity may be more. That's why we will add lime, some factor of safety, more quantity. Suppose lime is more, then what we have to do? For deliming process, we developed how to deliming by using lemon or by using citric acid, food grade citric acid. We standardize the process, and now we are giving training also to perfect jaggery without any deterioration, without any unhygienic. We are now for making the quality jaggery by using traditional method itself. Now process standardized lime quantity as well as deliming process. Then coming to the cool box method, that is second one is AFS, that is anti fermenting solutions available in the market from the CDB as well as SCMS Institute of Technology, and ours also now it is under processing. But coming to third one, there is a cool box. Initially we tried with locally available material for collecting the palmera palm, and CPCRA people developed for coconut, and they developed, one of the entrepreneurs, they developed one package and one collecting vessel. these are the our locally available thermocol box itself. We collected fresh nera without adding anything. If you see, observe in the box itself, thermocol inside one plastic container, and outside we will connect that pipe with connector to that spare, and the juice which is coming from the spare, it is coming into the box, and around the box we will put the ice for cooling purpose. The drop which is coming from the spare, it will directly goes to the container. By help of ice, it will maintain the cooling. So that cool chamber, so it will not allow to ferment, and it will be it is a delicious like amrutam. It is a sweet. It is a TSSR, that is a Brix content of more than 14. Sometimes it will goes to 17 also. It varies from the palm to palm. So if you observe in coconut water, it is a TSS is only 8. How much sweet it is? If you imagine, it is a TSS is more than 40 means how much sweet and how delicious. It is a energy. One can call it as an energy drink. Why? Because it contains so many energy values. It will come and like that. By using this cool box technology, we can collect fresh and natural juice, which is a like amrit. Similarly, we developed for both male palm, female palm, and from the fruits also we developed and we standardized that cool box technology for collecting the fresh unfermented chaff. Same, this one is from the collection of the fruit. This is the box developed by CPCRL, that for coconut they developed. Same was we implemented for palmera palm also. And we developed some locally available with Milton can also, that collecting vessels. We developed so many different types of collecting vessels by using that cooling gel or ice. And we replaced ice with gel pack and eutectic pads to maintain the cooling some more time. Now we are able to give the technologies or solutions for both male palm and female palm, as well as from the fruits for collecting the fresh chaff by using this cool box technology. And it is another process, another one variant in tribal areas. People, they use it to collect the young palms, which is not some areas they are not able to get the toddy in the off season. They try to get the toddy from the young palms to arresting the stem itself. After that palm will dies. This is for only observation purpose. Then if you see the fresh chaff collection through the cool box, here you can observe suppose male and female palm itself, lot of variation in nutritional values as well as composition as well as color also. Fresh chaff of this is a female palm, left side you can see that a nera collected from the female palm, right side from the male palm. And then coming to the shelf life, as I told, this is a very susceptible to atmosphere, and we have to maintain the cold chain entire the process. Once collecting from the palm itself, we have to take into the freezer immediately. Otherwise, it will bulge like, and it will starts fermentation by contacting with the atmospheric air and starts fermentation. So in this, we can see it is a processed nera one pack. Another one is unprocessed. So it will bulge like anything. So then coming to the some of the composition, which is the sap. It is a liquid. It is a Brix content, means sweetness and total sugars, protein, some basic values we studied. These are all you can get from our published papers also. Chaff is about from the average of from the each tree 2.5 to 3.5 liter per day per bunch for mature fruits, and it will give 90 to 100 days from each bunch of the tree. So one can imagine how many days we can tap from the palms. Then we studied some shelf life studies of that sap. Means why? Because this is the sap is the most economical part in the palmera palm. Then we can convert into the different value added part, that is very simple: jaggery, candy, chocolate, sugar. These are all. But we focused on the sap itself, different processing technologies by using chemical method, thermal method, and membrane processing also. And we developed technologies for 30 days to 2 months. So before going to the jaggery person, just some economic value of the each nera from the palms. Each palm gives average of 150 liters per year. So income generation from the each palm, you can see if we tap the 10% of the palms in Nera, it is we can have a scope of more than 18,000 crores in India. Means that much population is available in India. If a tapper uses, suppose one tapper uses 30 palms at the rate of 25 rupees, gives income of more than 1 lakh per month by using this. And by using this Nera utilization itself, we can employ the 10 lakh people employed. Means how much scope? It is generally in vague manner just I am giving. Then for a small unit, direct selling of Nera for 1 or 2 days and under refrigeration conditions, only freezer vans, refrigerator box with 3 to 4 lakhs, one small collection and basic processing and selling to the market, just like health beverage, fresh beverage. It is a 3 to 4 lakhs one small unit. For this, that KVIC giving some loans and subsidy also. Then coming to the our main core subject, our process it is. This is the Nera or unfermented sap or infusion sap. It is the palm juice. Which in what name we can any name we can call it. But this is the main source product to make the different products and our product jaggery. So for collection itself, we have to take care, and that is the depends upon the skill of the tapper and the hygienic of the tapper and method of the tapper and the palms and Nera quality, Nera yield also, palm to palm, lot of variation because it is wildly growing. There is no specific varieties and area to area. Suppose that's why we are not able to, although we have a sufficient data of each palm, but we are not able to specific recommendation because of the lot of variation is there. Palm to palm variation is there, area to area is the variation is there, some irrigation available means some lot of difference is there. Like that, lot of variation in the quality of the Nera and composition of the Nera. That's why anyway we have the average values of that composition. And once you collect the sap, either old method or new method or using the anti-permanent solution, that is the one process. After that, we can convert into the different value-added products. In this, suppose simple, without any investment, whatever a vessel available in our kitchen or bartan, we can convert into the jaggery. It is a simple process. So suppose if you take a fresh Nera, you keep on heating. If you take a sample of every half an hour, you can observe that how it is changing. So every half an hour, how it is changing. Just 2 to 3 hours, we can convert into the solid form or jaggery form or liquid jaggery or palm syrup by simple heating method. No issues. But that quality of the sap or quality of the Nera, we have to maintain strictly. That is the main thing in all the products. So coming to the here, see, that is a fresh Nera. Then we can convert into the palm syrup. That is the liquid. It is a bricks, around 65 to 68 bricks. It is a, like a honey. And like honey, and it is a syrup, and we can bottle it, and we can use it as a sweetener in all foods, all sweets. Whatever we are using sugar, cane sugar we can replace with this palm syrup, and we can convert into the crystal jaggery or jaggery powder. So this is the one photo of that is a palm syrup, similar to honey. It is made from the fresh sap of the male palm and female palm. That is dark color coming from the male palm, that light color is female palm. See, it is the same time and same time of heating, and how that color is changing and composition also various, male to female. This is the palm syrup from the 100% original and natural, nothing added. Simply collected that sap by using the cool box method and heated upon, took up to the 65 bricks under the stove itself. See, this is the palmara sap or palm syrup or a palm honey. One can call it as any name. It is a liquid jaggery we are calling, or palm syrup. Now we are selling this one also, half kg 100 rupees we are selling at our farm. And now one can store in this that is sealed bottle up to 1 year, and if once it is open, we can we have to keep the under refreshed conditions, otherwise light darkening of the syrup. Then coming to the jaggery or jaggery powder or crystal jaggery, they keep on heating, and we have to identify the stage of the slurry or syrup, and if you pour in the molds, it will give shapes, or keep on mixing with by hand also, or some crystallizers or some powder making machines, we can convert into the crystal jaggery or jaggery powder. If you observe in this is three types of jaggery powder. This is, if you see, this is a male palm and female palm, and it is a matured palm, nera collected from the fruit. See how it is variation is color itself, and it is a very sweet and very pleasant flavor. It is a 100% natural. Nowhere you can find this type of product at present. Why? Because this school bus technology, nobody using. The people who are doing this one, who are making this one, they are doing by traditional method only, by adding lime, that is excess lime, and for deliming purpose some other phosphoric acids they are adding. Because of this and all, this original quality is not giving to the present scenario. But here we developed, it is 100% natural and nothing added, zero addition. Simply keep on heating, and now we are trying for without heating also. But as per the due to that heating, some losses is there as compared to Nira nutritional less. Now we are focusing on freeze drying also. Now it is under process. So it is a 100% original natural jaggery which is developed at our station by using cool box methodology. It is the original color of the jaggery. Means the jaggery which is available in the market also, sometimes it is original, but color may be different due to the that lime. But here without lime or natural processing, means this is the original color. And from this we can make it so many types of products, the chocolates and jaggery powder also we can make into the granule form or in powder form also, and sugar. Then as you all know, sugar is the refined form of the jaggery. Refined form means that the first quality of the composition are sugars coming into the form of sugar. For this there are separate instruments or equipments needed. For crystallizers we needed there it some crystals form within a 48 hours by providing certain temperature and humidity, and we have to separate the crystals from the rab or liquid by using the centrifuge with high speed rotation. And after separation of the crystals, again we have to dry the dryer, that is a fluid bed dryer. Why? Because that crystals are containing the surface some moisture. If you dry natural drying means it will stick on. We have to go for fluid bed drying or more surface area drying we have to do. For this, the three equipment needed for this sugar. It is a refined form of the jaggery only, nothing else. And there is no bleaching agents we are using. Simply crystal separating and making the powder form. So that's why that color is not in white. For whitening of the sugar also we can go, but we have to use lot of chemicals and worn meals and all. But here nothing is added, only that first grade crystals was separated and making powder. So it is for crystal or candy making process we developed some lab model. Now we developed for industrial scale also. In this way, suppose one inverted V shaped tray with ropes, and we concentrated the palm sap up to the 72 bricks, and keep in this that tray for 35 days, it will start forming the crystals like this for candy making or patik bellam or palm candy. Like this we can get different after 35 to 40 days based on the climatic condition, this type of crystals will get, that is a palm candy. So in similar manner, different in palm candy also we can separate by washing and drying, first quality, second quality, third quality, and again wrap liquid will be there. Then again that liquid can be used by palm in the mixing in the palm jaggery. Palm jaggery is the crude form of entire sap. That's why nothing is waste in this processing. First quality we can separate, the second quality all we can add into the jaggery making itself. So in this nothing is waste. So this is also some matured palm. Earlier I shown jaggery from the male palm and female palm. Here from the fruit also we can collect the sap and we can made it jaggery. See how the color is, that natural jaggery, nothing is added in this. Same it is jaggery powder or crystal jaggery, means after keep on heating while last stage keep on mixing, and by removing the heat like that some lumps will form. This is we can call it as a crystal jaggery. And and we have a scientific data of both traditional method as well as our new method. In this also we analyzed a composition of the nutritional values, which is here iron and phosphorus, ascorbic acid and calcium, which is very less facilities we are having in our laboratories. They are analyzed and we sent to samples to other laboratories in Kerala, in Tamil Nadu and Kakinada. We have another data also. Now we are pulling up all the data. Anyway, it is all Nera or either jaggery having a full of nutrition values and micronutrients, calcium, magnesium, phosphorus. That is the main useful things for our health purpose. Then coming to the in traditional processing, which is going on in Andhra Pradesh, it is the in one sheet itself. See, one tapper collecting the sap from the, he will select the specific palms which is high yielding by way of his experience. Each palm he will collect more than 10 liters, around 10 to 15 liters. By using 20 to 25 palms, he will collect 250 liters per day and hand over to the wife. His wife, it's she, it's he himself making jaggery, and they are earning 4 months 4 lakhs income. It is a live example, and I have written one article also in Agri Clinic. 4 months 4 lakhs income in near Chagallu of West Godavari district. Every year they will start from the February month, and June they will close the processing. Why? Because that is the peak season, and they will earn 4 lakhs for 4 months. It is a proven with how much demand in the market. They are not going to anywhere. The people are coming to their huts or their field to purchase the palm jaggery. So in an unorganized sector also, how much importance it is. But without knowing any statistics, it is selling like anything. Huge demand is here. Now we are getting huge calls, and daily we are getting calls from different places, but we are not able to supply in other places. Anyway, we are selling at our counter at the rate of 400 rupees per kg. This year, up to this before lockdown, we sold more than 2 lakhs worth of jaggery this year itself. See how much demand, how much awareness without any means public advertisement and every any publicity. Now lot of awareness is there, and lot of useness, people are observing very much useful, and its utilization. So based on this, now we have a plant, mini processing plant, Palmera processing unit at our station. Now we are giving a training as well as marketing of the products of the all products. Now we got FSSAI license also. Because of the license issues, so only Nera we are not selling. Other products, jaggery, candy, sugar and palm syrup, we are selling, but due to lockdown we stopped the unit before lockdown. Now we started. Now we have available a jaggery and palm syrup at our station. This is our inside view of the station. We have different equipments. This is the jaggery making, manual jaggery making at our station. These are all views of the our stations. So these are the products we are making at our plants, that Nera, jaggery, palm syrup, candy and jaggery powder and chocolates. So what are the products available from the Palmera palm? So 1 kg of jaggery from 8 liters of Nera, and 1 kg of sugar from 12 liters of Nera, and 1 kg of candy from 14 liters of Nera. If 10% of the palms used in the jaggery or sugar or candy at the rate of 400 rupees we are selling, total revenue means how much possibility is there in India for by using the by available. It is 120 million of palms are available in India. So with this, how much employment we can create, one can imagine. It is all approximations only. So then these are all the process of jaggery and the process behind the jaggery, and what are the technical aspects in brief. I'm not going to the any statistical values any numerical values of the sap and collection, and that is a big subject. So these are all the collection of the neera and jaggery making. Now coming to the uses of jaggery. So in olden days also, if we see the Vastukuna Deepika or Vedas, lot of things is there about the jaggery, because of by the way of experience, by the gay of their uses, they already given in broad sense. Now also so many clinical trials and so many laboratory analysis basis, so there are so many uses. So it is a rich, iron rich, so one can use daily 3 to 5 grams, means you can observe within a month a drastic change on your health by improving the hemoglobin and levels in the blood. It is a live examples of many of my customers I am giving to the jaggery to many people every year. Similarly, magnesium, potassium, whatever the micronutrients required for human body, it is available in the palm jaggery, based on the lab reports as well as many other grandhas also. It is a calcium, zinc, phosphorus, and for nervous system, magnesium needed. Sometimes some people may be feeling some weaknesses because of low levels of micronutrients. So whatever the body requirements, that micronutrient, it is all available in the palm jaggery, and good source of vitamin B complex, which is useful for our boosting the immune system and our repair the cellular damage like that. And one another important thing is it is a low glycemic value. As you all know, maybe you know about the glycemic index or glycemic value. It is the glycemic index means how the food is entering into the our blood or mixing into the blood, how much time it will take place. Based on that the glycemic index will be defined. The food whichever we are using, all it is a glycemic index is almost 50 or more than 50. In general, less than 50 GI is very useful for health, and more than 50 is somewhat good. But if it is more than 70, it is very dangerous to health, because it will immediately goes into the blood and it will leads to the increase the blood glucose levels. So whereas in this palm product, it is already scientifically proved, already so much publications available, that GI is around 35 to 40, less than 40. That's why because of this composition of the sucrose molecule, and it will enter into the blood very slowly. Suppose if you take 200 ml of neera or 5 grams of jaggery in the morning itself, you will not feel hungry up to almost afternoon or evening. Why? Because it will take very slow, and it will hunger free, and it will be very energy. So that's why one can consider it as a energy drink or sports drink in earlier days itself. So like that, if you tell, means so many uses. It will already some publications also available. It activates the digestive enzymes, and whatever the requirement of acids to digestion system, it will regulate the acids in our stomach. Similarly, and we cannot give recommendation to cure the diabetic, but one can say it is a diabetic friendly. It will not affect the diabetic. So diabetic patients also, they can take whatever the required level. Means anything more, means it will affect in another manner. So it is, if you take daily 3 to 5 grams in any manner, either tea, coffee, or any other manner, it will be very much useful for diabetic patients also. It is already proven, so many people are using, and so many they are giving feedback also. And similarly, it is having a antioxidant activity, and it is an energy booster, and it is all sometimes in summer it is using as some cooling effect. And also in olden days, some pregnant ladies also, they are giving to clean the blood, by it will remove the toxins, as well as it give the iron for the pregnant women. That's why it is very much essential for mainly pregnant women and children who are suffering from anemic. And in the ancient days also, that palm candy, which is derived product of the jaggery itself, it is used as a remedy for cough or cold, but throat infection. If you take one piece of that palm candy or patikabellum, It will stop the throat infection or cough. This is already that to prevent details is available. Similarly, there are so many uses from the prevent the constipation, and you will not feel weakness, and it will boost our immune system by because of that is preventing the free radical damage and promoting the resistance for infections. It is a live example. So many people, including me, since 4 years I am doing this one. As it is like drastic changes you can observe within a month if you use regularly 3 to 5 grams of jaggery. Similarly, it is useful for regulate the body system by giving the sufficient minerals and micronutrients, and for it will regulate the weight also. Like that in some articles recently, one Osmania professor studied, it is having a elements of that which is useful for cancer or medicine. The medicine which is useful for cancer, the components of same thing observed in the palm sap or jaggery. So that's why, and some earlier days by mixing with ginger and by using this to remove the kidney stones or to avoid the stone formation, this jaggery combined with ginger. Like that, as I told earlier, that Mahatma Gandhi recommended the jaggery in rural areas. Instead of sugar, if you use this palm jaggery, it will slowly affect the blood sugar. That's why it will not affect directly glucose level or sugar levels. And it is highly priced due to the medicinal properties and due to the recovery. It is, we'll get from the 8 to 10 liters of the sap, we'll get only 1 kg of jaggery. And for making cost and processing, and one can go climb the palm and tap. That's why somewhat it is highly priced. And as I told earlier, so many kashayams there in Ayurveda itself, they are using lot of medicines for in Ayurveda. They are using jaggery only. Jaggery itself acting as a medicinal values. Last year we supplied more than 2,000 bottles of liquid jaggery to the Ayurvedic people. So one can imagine how much useful this one. So like this, suppose pure jaggery or natural sap or natural sap based products, means it will give like anything. Like that, these are the so many benefits. What not, if we can in any way. Simply now we are focusing and I am giving the so many lectures in Doordarshan Saptagiri and 10 TV, Maha TV also. Now our concept is health and wealth. By using the rural areas, one can improve the health chance of the people, as well as they will get the income. And now our target is to replace the sugar bowl in the kitchen of the every people with palm sugar or palm jaggery or palm syrup. That will leads to health standards of the people, and it as well as income level of the rural people, the people who are making or tapping in this field. Now we focus that is up to the jaggery making and the uses of the jaggery, and numerical values also. We have so many values, how much that is the scientific research papers I published, as well as so many people published, and lot of work is going on in Sri Lanka, and unfortunately in India nobody working on this. We are the only one institute working in this palm products and palm processing, and now we observe that lot of people, they are adding the cane sugar into the palm jaggery while making itself. So that's why they will sugar cost is very cheap. That's why they will get very high price by using this one. That's why lot of adulteration is going on. For that, we concentrated on this to identify the adulteration by some chemical method. We are able to develop that protocol for identify the either cane sugar mixing, either jaggery mixing or charcoal powder mixing, or simply we can see that suppose generally palms jaggery is whatever that lime jaggery is dark color, but I shown that pure jaggery somewhat golden color to dark brown, and but whatever that lime jaggery means dark brown color but soft in nature, but whatever jaggery is very hard means that is definitely they are mixed with that cane sugar while making itself, and it will give long shelf life also. But that original lime jaggery, it will not give shelf life more than 15 days. Then it will, Once it is open, it will absorb the moisture from the atmosphere and it will be sticky. That is original jaggery made with lime method. But whereas the pure method, which is developed by us, now nobody is doing. That is to maintain the moisture content by using the drying methods. Then we can keep under packing method up to 6 months. 6 months in open area also, and under refrigeration conditions more than 1 year also. But whatever jaggery available in the present in the market, that is the most of the lime method only. That is mainly very less shelf life, and it will become a slurry type, and it will absorb the moisture after 15 days, and it will be soft in nature. But it is when it is hard means they will add something, either cane jaggery or cane sugar. That is the main criteria. Others also now we are developing protocols for the same. So for jaggery unit with simple our own kitchen vessel also we can prepare, or some other. With the minimum small scale unit with 5 lakhs, we can set up 60 kg per day. Jaggery can be installed, or we can go for boiler, steam in large scale also. But main thing is here raw material collection and skilled tappers. And now that all farms are in not in organized manner, but in our farm we are having organized manner. But in outside it is wildly along the roadside, along the tracks, along the wastelands. But we have to pull up the number of farms more, and we have to manage the things at ground level. Raw material collection itself a very tedious process. We have to focus on that. If we have a good team of tapping and collection means, then we can success in the jaggery making. So these are all about the jaggery and future. Now government also focusing lot of thing in palm resources in village level. Recently we submitted to report to parliament also. How utilize the palm resources for developing health products in rural areas. Now in government also formed one committee, last government, it is under process. So I think we are hope that in future days or coming years, a lot of boom is coming. Now recently Telangana government also given one letter to us to train the people about this palm products, and they sanctioned amount also. But due to this lockdown, we stopped temporarily. Now Telangana government started the Nera and the Nera based products in large scale. They issued Jiva also. In future, it will become in plenty of scale, and a lot of demand also is there. We are getting inquiries from abroad also. In Sri Lanka, small country, they are exporting more than 10 crores of worth every year with the traditional method jaggery only. They are not having any scientific approach. Now recently, they contacted us for the MOU to give the technology of these process technology of our sap collection, processing, and value-added products. Now, this is the situation about the palm trees and palm-based products in briefly. And another, in one line, we are have developed palm tuber, that is called Tyagalu. We developed tuber flour and tuber rava, and standard process for bakery products, all noodles, pizza, biscuits, cookies, by replacing maida with tuber flour and sugar with palm sugar. Similarly, we developed different value-added products from the nungu, that is tender sport or munjalu, candy, sorbet, squash, jam, jelly, and another one, palmara fruit, ripened fruit. It is a naturally available, good colored and good nutrition values. We developed a fruit bar and drink, fruit beverage, as well as health mix. And so on, some other products from the spongy endosperium, copra, and other non-edible leaf articles, fiber-based products also from the palmara. These are all about our research area, our products. This is up to this. Now it is open for discussion. Anybody wants questions, then I am ready to clarify. Thank you, sir. Sudhir, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Venge, sir. You covered all the details A to Z, and most of the topics you covered, right from the farmer to processor and the consumer. You covered all the points very well. Now to the participants, please raise your hands. If you have any still question, we can ask. You can open the unmute. And yeah, there are many basic questions like how to find a good palm jaggery. You already covered most of the stuff. And yes, next question is where we get. So for that, I would like to answer like, no, buy always from a trusted stores, and don't buy for a cheap quality or less quality, less price. And you know, these things you need to buy only from the trusted parties. Otherwise, we need to satisfy whatever is available that is a good quality. And also yes, many are asking how to reach your research center and how can they can approach for forming or scaling in the commercial entities. For that, you have any contact number? You please share that.
Yes sir. You can contact any time our Autocad Research Station Pandirmavadi. It is near Rampachodavaram, East Godavari. It is 50 kilometers from the Rajahmundry. We have a small processing unit also. It is under Rashtriya Krishi Vikas Yojana of central government funded. Now it is in working condition. You can visit our unit also at any time. It is a worth of more than 1.5 crore. Why? Because we are hauling all the systems. That is jaggery making, neera and sugar making for all the modes, either traditional manner or automation, I mean mechanization model with steam boilers. We are maintaining all the systems for demo as well as commercial mode. So you can visit our unit, our station anytime. Now we are started selling also products. Now one by one we are improving the every year due to shortage of the manpower, and now we are stabilizing all the process. So now we are commercializing, we are giving the trainings, we are concentrating moreover R&D as well as into the skill development programs. And recently we got the approval of the AP Skill Development Corporation for training of the youth in Andhra Pradesh. It is actually scheduled in the month of April, but due to the lockdown it was postponed.
Yeah. And also to just to add that value, there is a saying called Kalpavrushyam, and many people will think coconut tree is the Kalpavrushyam, but it is wrong information. Palm yes. tree is the Kalpavrushyam in the ancient days. Now yes. at one point of time it got changed to coconut tree, and you know many are asking whether we can buy the palm jaggery available on the roadside.
Yes.
Unless you know is that trusted or genuine farmers, then don't buy. Mostly it's the yes. adulterated with the sugarcane jaggery.
And yes, sir.
Yeah.
One thing I want to add here, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. Sir, in Hyderabad, one firm that PPRPF, one fellow that is Arun Kumar Pandey, is a brand of sweet tea. He is making jaggery at one unit having a Salem, and he is making with the brand of sweet tea in some stores in Kuppatpalli. Also, he is selling, sir, sweet tea brand. It is a good quality. He is maintaining quality standards of both wild dead palm jaggery as well as Palmyra palm jaggery.
Yeah, so I will share those numbers and details in the NELG groups. All you need to do is just
yes, I will share. Yes, yes, I have some. Yeah, I will share, sir. I will share all the things.
Yeah, Meghnaad ji, ask your question. Unmute yourself.
Hello.
Hello.
Tell me,
madam. Yeah, madam.
Hello.
Yeah, madam. Hello.
Yeah, I think Meghnaad ji, unmute yourself, please. Okay, we'll take the next question. Raghav Agarwal. Please unmute yourself, sir. Okay. Yeah, ask your question.
Yeah. Emandi, Telugu lo adugutanandi.
Chappandi, sir.
Emandi, ippudu ekarallo oka 500 chettlu esukoni ee maavidi chettla laga idi kuda deenni pandinchachcha, idi viability unda?
Sir. Sir, there is one issue in that, sir. Hmm. 1 minute, sir. Just.
My question is, can we cultivate this as a commercial crop just like mango tree or coconut tree?
Yeah, yes, I am coming to that one, sir. That is, as on that, there is no hybrids and there is no short varieties, there is no early varieties, sir. Now that that palm coming into the yield itself more than 12 years, sir.
Hmm.
That's why it will take time, and that's why. This is a long duration crop. Suppose now so many people trying for to develop hybrids and tissue culture. Now it is under processing, sir. Now a lot of private people are also coming from Hyderabad. Recently we conducted one meeting with collaboration tissue culture. We started, sir. But as on that, from the seedlings, it will take more time. But anyway, you can go. Now in Rayalaseema also, some of the people, they started cultivation by 10 meter by 10 meter by using another intercultural operations also, sir.
At least on the border side we can put it.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Wonderful, sir. We need your number, sir.
Yeah, yes, I'll share those numbers, sir. If you are in NELG groups, okay. I will share.
Thank you.
Yeah, Meghnaad ji. Meghnaad ji, unmute yourself, please. Okay. We'll take the next question, Sunita ji. Sunita ji.
Hi. Yeah. Hello. Hello, sir. This is.
Hello.
Tell me, madam.
Hello.
Yeah, please go on.
Yeah.
Do you want me to talk or the other
yes,
lady?
Yes, please talk.
Okay, I thank you for this wonderful presentation. It was so clear. I just have one query about seeing organic jaggery mentioned on packets. Now, jaggery is natural, and why is it that it's marketed as organic in some packets? Because there's no such thing as organic jaggery, right? So I was a bit confused when I see organic mentioned against jaggery packets.
Yeah, but generally palm jaggery means naturally it is organic only. Man, there is nobody giving fertilizers, pesticides, nothing irrigation. It is naturally grown palms, that is whatever wild date palm, that fishtail palm and palmer palm. These are all wildly grown. Nobody is giving any chemicals. It is naturally available in around the forest, nearby wastelands or roadsides. That's why it is naturally, it is organic only. That's why that certification also they are giving easily, madam, for this palm jaggery and all certification also.
Yes, I understand, but I come from Dubai and I often see organic mentioned against some jaggeries. And when I ask them, what do you mean by organic? When I know that it comes from India and it's natural, how can you tell me this is organic? And then they just tell me, oh, the processing is different. So I'm like, no, it can't be.
One good thing is you're talking about the sugarcane jaggery or palm jaggery?
Palm. I'm not talking about sugarcane.
Yeah, madam, in palm jaggery also, some of the people in Tamil Nadu, they are adding some chemicals, some preservatives. That's why that is not come under the organic jaggery. But who are doing the traditional method and without adding anything, it will comes under organic jaggery. Processing itself, it will
affect the processing also. But the problem is, because we don't get your jaggery here, so how would a lay person know which is then the good jaggery if it's... Only if we see is it from color? How would I know? Like, I don't have the expertise in jaggery or with the taste or something. So my problem is, then do I only choose organic jaggery? Or is there a certification, something that I see that tells me this is natural and, I should buy only from this? Because I see so many jaggeries in the market. So many. Yeah. Very hard to...
Yeah. And in the presentation, we already covered those topics and points. Okay. And in the going forward, I will make some official post on how to identify and know the stuff. The thumb rule is buy from the trusted sources.
Done. Okay.
Yeah. And next thing, Meghanaji, please ask your question. Meghanaji, unmute yourself and ask your question. Now
hello?
You ask. Yeah.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yes. How to store this? Do we have to store in the fridge? Otherwise, get the fungus in the palm jaggery.
Yeah, madam, it is
white fungus.
That traditional process jaggery, they will not maintain the moisture content of the jaggery, madam. Simply, they will put in the mold and they are selling. That's why due to the high moisture content and due to the naturally hygroscopic nature, it will absorb the moisture in outside. If you keep in the refrigerator, it will not spoil. Otherwise, you can keep in the airtight container.
Okay, but we have to keep in the fridge?
Yeah, madam, you can keep in the fridge.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, Meghnach, just to add that, basically I prefer is the ingredient that naturally made or what is currently outside available, it is not, you can't store it more than 2 to 3 months. So consume within that period and buy planning accordingly.
Okay.
Yeah. Venkateshwarlu garu.
Unmute cheyalandi. పామ్ జాగరి అంటే తాటి బెల్లం అంటుంటాం కదా మామూలుగా ఈత బెల్లానికి ఇంగ్లీష్ లో మరి వైల్డ్ డేట్ జాగరి అంటారా మనకి ఎక్కడ కనపడదు అది తాటి బెల్లం కనపడుతుంది కానీ ఈత బెల్లం ఎక్కడ కనపడదు చేస్తారు అది కూడా
అది బెంగాల్ లో ఎక్కువ చేస్తారు సార్ బెంగాల్ లో స్వీట్స్ కూడా మొత్తం ఈత బెల్లం చేస్తారు బెంగాల్
అది ఏది బెటర్ హెల్త్ కి ఏది బెటర్ రెండిల్లో
ఆల్మోస్ట్ సిమిలర్ వన్ సార్ మనకు లైట్ కాంపోజిషన్ డిఫరెంట్ కానీ మెయిన్ పర్పస్ ఇస్ ఆల్మోస్ట్ సిమిలర్ సార్ ఈత తాటి అండ్ జీరుగ బెల్లం అంటే ఫిష్ టైల్ పామ్ బెల్లం కూడా ఉంటుంది అన్నమాట ఆల్మోస్ట్ సిమిలర్ ఉంటాయి
ఓకే సార్
అనిత గారు
హౌ డు వి రీచ్ యు ఫర్ యువర్ ప్రొడక్ట్స్ డు యు సెల్ దెం ఆన్లైన్
Yeah. So I said we should be using palm jaggery in our village in Karnataka. My question is, now some like one period is once we wheel the this mulch.
Prathaj, ask your question.
I have got basically two questions here. The first question is, I just wanted to know the what are the type of soil conditions and the water requirement that is there to maintain a palm jaggery for its effectiveness, and is the maintenance of this is it a cumbersome process, because nowadays manpower, getting proper manpower is now it's difficult. Because I remember my granny who used to stay in village, they used to say that they don't get workers, you know, who used to climb the coconut tree are not available. And nowadays, those are the things, are the difficulties which is normally faced in villages. So I just wanted to know that, is it possible for any layman to have a soil condition and sustainability type of living it is there? Is it possible? That's point number one. Is it possible to do that? Second, I want to know from health benefits, when a person, you say that it is very good for the people who are having type 2 diabetes and whose this thing level is around 6, less below 6. So is there any the application? What are the various applications? Just by eating the jaggery can just in the raw form, will it help, or even for this, or it needs to be mixed up with ginger or something like that? Just wanted to have a little fair idea on that. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Sir, first question, are you asking about the palm trees cultivation or jaggery making process, sir?
No, it is the cultivation, because as I said, sir, that it is very useful for the farmers and every today I'm finding in Maharashtra and many places today, all the who and cry,
yes,
things the farmers are suffering. But looking into your vision and statement, I was wondering, why are my farmers suffering so much? Because today in all the news media,
yes, sir.
So I was wondering this. So is it that soil conditions are not proper, or the maintenance is not proper, or water, or is it the climate that is not suitable? Because nowadays, because of climatic conditions getting changed, it is affecting. So I just wanted to have a little feel. Is there a discrepancy what the media is promoting and what's really the ground reality? Because I stay in Dubai, so I'm not really aware of the ground condition.
Yeah, yeah. Sir, continue the answer, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Actually, sir, in villages, it is a lot of scope either, but as you know, now nobody interested to do in the agriculture sector. That is a big issue. I think you know all the people. Now, many people who are recently, one of my friend from the software, he written back and he started cultivation. Like that now, in a scientific manner, in a large scale, some business scale or industry scale, people are coming and starting. Otherwise, small and marginal farmers, single farmer can't afford to do by due to lack of the labor and lack of the workmanship in villages. Now recently in Telangana, Bodhan area, one Dr. Apreddi Garu, he started more than 20 acres by planting of the fishtail palms. In future, he want to start his own jaggery unit in the field itself. So like the systems need to be started, sir. Otherwise, single one person, they can make their home purpose or for own consumption, one can made simply, easily, no issues. But if you want to go for commercial means, you have to start in industrial mode or entrepreneurship mode.
Yeah. Okay. And one more thing, says, there is no demand for the palm jaggery. Say, suppose if the 40 rupees per kilo, you are getting a sugar cane and sugar, and nobody is ready to purchase for 300 rupees per kg. Because now we feel that sugar is very good and the farmers are producing and the processing centers are developing. But that is a byproduct of molasses. That means they make alcohol from the sugar cane. And the waste, yes, from the waste, they will make sugar, and to make it as a white, they add more chemicals, bleaching agents, all the stuff, which are making people sick and which are creating many cancers. So once we have a demand, then definitely there is a more scope and more employment in the villages.
Yes, yes, sir. Now, sir, yes, sir, it is one thing I observed, sir. It is the demand is there, sir, but people are not that sure and secure. Now, without publicity, now we are having a huge demand. Now, I am not able to supply, sir. I got inquiries from Canada, US also, sir, by seeing the in Google website itself.
Yeah. Now, the last 1 or 2 years, the demand got more, awareness got increased, and now the things are changing.
Yeah. Sir, now, suppose medicine cost is more, sir, we can sell it as a medicine in small chocolates, small cubes like that. Just like you can utilize as a medicine, less quantity, more people can use it. Like in similar manner, we have to plan, sir.
Sir,
is it for a layman like us, do we need to study this to enter into this field?
Yes, 100%, sir. No issues, sir.
Okay.
Yeah. I think we can go to the next question. Sir, there are many, fruits are also from the palm trees, right? So is there any way to naturally process it and preserve that? That is another question.
Yes, yes. Already we developed, we have a plant also, sir. Palmyra fruit, I can give one example, sir. Suppose mango, by giving so many inputs, so much expenditure, we are getting a fruit of. But in Palmyra, in naturally, each palm having a more than 200 fruits, and it is a good in color, and whatever the composition in nutrition value is more than that of mango, it is a free of cost, we are able to get that pulp. From each fruit, we will get 300 grams of pulp. For one tree itself, almost more than 50 to 100 kg of pulp available without any input cost. Simply, we will collect the fruit during the season. From that, we developed that fruit bud. Earlier, one can call it a tandra, sir. We developed in a hygienic way with adding that some palm sugar for maintaining the sweetness and with remove the bitterness. Hygienic way with gold color fruit bar we developed, sir. And recently one private firm also asked us to technology transfer, Tirupati based at Nutrino company, sir.
Okay. So if anyone visit your center, they can get more details on preserving the fruit pulp.
Yes, fruit pulp as well. And health mix from the fruit also, we developed a flour. It is a good color flour. One can mix with idli, dosa, any wheat and rice flour, we can use this flour.
Okay.
And similarly, palm tuber, that is tagalu. From that, we developed flour and replaced maida in all bakery items, noodles, pizza, and cookies, biscuits, cakes and all.
Another question is, what is the right time to reach your institute?
The right time means generally now, actually, season of full peak season. And throughout the year, we lose somewhere one product, sir. It is a palms means now Nera season about to ending, that Nera and Jaggery season. Then we will start now that we are processing that Munjalu, tender fruit, understand? We are making jam, jelly, and osmotic dehydrated products of the Munjalu. That Munjalu, to keep the availability of the throughout the year, that tenders put endosperm based value added products now we are doing. And after that, July onwards, we will start that pulp processing. Pulp product, now this year we are planning to sell fruit bar and maja like drink, fruit beverage, as well as health mix from July, August onwards.
Yeah.
Again, from the December, we will start selling of Neera, Jaggery and candy and all.
Okay, got it. So anyone want to reach, they can simply Google your research institute address in the Google and they can get it. Otherwise, we can share in the NELG groups as well. Next question, Samir ji.
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yes.
Yeah, I have two questions. Good evening, doctor. One is, if I have to purchase Jaggery from you directly, how do I go about it? And the second question is, whether if we consume jaggery with that is prepared by lime, is it safe, or should we go for the jaggery produced naturally, that is by you or by your method?
In olden days, jaggery means lime jaggery only. It is 100% safe, no issues. But due to the, suppose some people, they are not able to exact quantity of jaggery due to the excess lime. Maybe some implications, maybe are not able to that much good taste and all, but excess times leads to some store formation, that is different effect. But once old method also, they will do properly deliming process means it is also good.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, that was the question. And if I want to purchase directly from you, so it will take time, as you mentioned earlier.
Pardon, sir?
No, yes. If they want to reach, the store has to open and you have to reach this place. Otherwise, we need to wait for their online store.
Okay. Okay, that's it.
Now we are selling at our counter only, sir. Why? Because it is a government institute. We have so many permissions, so many sanctions we needed. Now we are planning in near future, at least December onwards, we are planning to sell in large scale, sir.
Yeah. Shashi ji.
Hello.
Yeah.
So my question was like for babies we give this ragi malt with the jaggery. So my question is, what is the minimum age to give this palm jaggery?
No minimum age, madam. Anybody can take.
From 6 months child, 6 months child can have it, yes, in his home.
Yes. Very small quantity we can give, madam. Now in agency areas, if you see just born babies, they are feeding with it sap, fresh sap. They are calling it, it is a Thalli Pala Chettu. They are calling it as
yeah, I know.
Mother milk palm, like that they are calling it. Yes. In similar composition. That's what means based on the digestion system, it should be accomplished with that digestion. Very less quantity we can mix with some liquids, we can give marrow in carrot juice and all, we can add.
Yeah, we give in ragi malt. So I have one more question, like my village is in Karnataka, so we have lots of coconut trees, okay? Now for regarding this growing of palm tree, I will get in touch with you soon for sure. My one more important question is, like, can you just give me a rough idea of how much quantity of palm jaggeries produced presently in India? Is it equal to the number of sap that is collected? Why I'm asking you is because 25 years back, when you used to consume palm jaggery, it was so tasty. Now, if I go into my village and have it, by tasting it, I can make it, it's not genuine. Sugarcane, as Sir said, it has been mixed or something, some other ingredient. So is it really, because I believe palm trees are getting extinct in India, but the amount of palm jaggery that is produced is more than what is being, that's my calculation I've seen from the last 25 years. So can you...
Yes, madam. Absolutely, madam. Now, very less quantity of palm jaggery people are making. And in that almost more than, we collected last year 20 samples. Among the 20 samples, 17 was adulterated, madam, with cane sugar.
Yes.
So yeah, how, like that scenario is there, madam.
So difficult to rely on the villager also. Like, it's so difficult.
Yeah. Villager itself by earning. Now, people, motto is only earning money. Like that, many of the people, madam. It is just, I am quoting here.
Okay.
Fine, sir.
Thank you so much.
Yeah. Mukesh ji.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello. Want to know the difference between palm jaggery and date jaggery available in Bengal, Kolkata side?
Yeah, in Bengal only date palm jaggery available. Maximum in Tamil Nadu, palmara jaggery people are making.
Okay, any difference?
Yes, sir. Means slightly that composition, some composition, that micronutrients composition levels are slightly different.
Okay, yeah, we got that. Yeah, next question, Maruti Garu.
Yes.
Yeah, please ask your question.
Sir, I want to know how to preserve the fruit pulp. At home, we will be getting fruits. So I want to know how to preserve the fruit pulp.
Homemade, so many technologies available, madam, by simple preservatives or by making with pasteurization method and with glass bottles with some pasteurized, you can store in glass bottles by adding a food additives of like KMS or citric acid. The simple methods, it is available in Google also. You can get homemade pulp preservation, it is available. Otherwise, I can share the entire flowchart of that one.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Adi Garu.
Venkai Garu, namaste, Andy.
Namaste, sir.
Actually, మేము కూడా ఏజెన్సీలో ఒక ఫామ్ లో లెమన్ గ్రాస్ అది పండిస్తున్నాం. సో అందుకనే క్యూరియస్ అబౌట్ మన ఈ చోడవరంలో ఉన్న కేవీకే సెంటర్ లో మీరు కల్టివేట్ చేసి మీరు అమ్మే అది అక్కడ దొరుకుతుందండి?
ఫామ్ సార్, yes sir, we are having a germplasm, sir. NPP they are approved. In India, suppose anybody wants information about the palmara, they will contact me as also, sir. We are the only institute having a germplasm of 285 types of palmara germplasm, sir. And it is named, given by National Bureau of Plant Genetics. They are identified this germplasm.
Okay. No, the other question is, ippudu meeru inkoka answer question ki answer cheppetappudu November December time March varaku meer annaru jaggery will be the primary product that use kadandi. Ippudu if we are buying things outside of that window of time, and ippudu let's say summer varaku jaggery baane untadi, dan tarvata adulteration ekku undochandi?
Yes sir, whenever that nera available reducing means they will start adulteration more.
Okay, so and that means we have to buy only during this period to really be sure about the product.
Yes, March, April abundantly available in March and April.
And is it available? I mean, primarily the production of palm jaggery, is it only in the south, or is it like weather dependent, or let us say if it's in the other regions like cold places, is there a production in other than this window of time, like November to March time kakuna vere time lo kuda other places they produce the palm jaggery?
No, sir, actually in very less quantity, maybe some palms off season it will give near a very less quantity. In our farm we are doing entire the year, but very less quantity. Maybe some palms off season it is giving, and we are extending the by different tapping methods, so, but season throughout the year. But main peak season is December to May, April, February, April, 3 months full peak season. Up to May, we can June first week it will available.
I see. Okay.
Next question, Samir ji.
Yeah. Good evening, doctor. Are you at home? How do we test whether it is pure or adulterated with cane sugar?
Yes, sir. Generally, sir, cane sugar mixing means you will find that hard in nature. If you taste in biting, means you will feel that some sugar crystal feel you will get.
Okay.
That is main thing. And general palm sugar means it is in soft in nature. Soft in nature.
Okay. Any color difference between two?
And color also light color means they are very light color, and means it will sugar added, and upon the surface some white patches means sugar crystal formation means, so some whitish is there means that is 100% adulterated, but it is okay, in okay. brown color in soft nature means it is a pure jaggery.
Okay, thank you,
sir. I saw a palm jaggery from a vendor which is light golden color but very hard.
Very hard means either he was added in palm sugar or otherwise some phosphoric acid or some additives or preservatives he might have added.
Okay, yeah. The last question from Marthi Gar. Please unmute yourself. Okay, I'm not able to unmute you. Please unmute or we can wind up the today's session. Yeah, please ask your question.
Can we use this pulp of the fruit instead of jaggery?
Pardon, madam?
Hello? Can we use the fruit pulp instead of jaggery?
Fruit pulp means that is a main raw material, madam. We have to make different products with that. That is just like any other fruit pulp. We can make into the flour, or we can make into the fruit bar, or we can mix with rava or rice flour, and we can make in different products.
Oh, like that. How to make powder of it?
It is a simple foam mat drying, madam. It is a one method is there. We have to develop the foam by using the some people, non-veg people, egg white or some foaming agents is there. Means why it is in sticky in nature, that we have to go for foaming first by mixing with blender or mixer or grinder. After that, if you can dry in solar drying or in sun drying also, dry it and mixing. Going for pulverizer or mixing, it will be flour, madam.
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay.
We got one more question, then this is the last question. Yadagiri garu,
sir, can we make palm syrup at home, sir, by purchasing the neera in our area?
Yes, sir.
How can we make, sir?
Sir, it is based on the quantity. If it is very, suppose 10 liters, if we can only small bartan in your kitchen itself, we can make in
stove itself,
we can make, sir. No problem.
Okay. What are the things to be added, sir? Only lime?
No, suppose that based on the collection methods. Uh-huh. We do, no need of anything adding, sir. While collection itself, if uh-huh. we are not going for that cool pass technology, any anti-permanent solution, we have to add lime. Otherwise, another method. While collection itself, once collection means nothing to be added, simply heating only, we have to add. Check the pH and TSS that for quality parameters to maintain the uniform quality or correct quality.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you, Vengai Garu, for patiently asking answering all the questions. Mudho, many are repeated. Yeah, and again, within 1 hour, we can't cover the subject because very vast and very useful, very helpful. Yes, sir. And yes, I say, don't go for sugarcane jaggery because very mostly water demanding crop. As most disasters to the ecological way and environment also. If you're possible, try to know and start using the palm jaggery. That is the small request for the participants. And thank you, Vengai Garu, for your time and effort and for sharing your experiences. Yes. And with this, we'll conclude this today's webinar. Thank you all.
Yes. Thank you.